I grew up with a disability. I have a visual condition which makes it difficult for me to see properly, to navigate or to drive a vehicle. And so growing up, I have always found myself depending on others for my mobility needs, which was an incredibly constraining experience, especially in the formative years.
In like many NGOs, UN, it's very difficult to have a conversation with that peoples. It's very difficult to have conversation with them. I used to pay a lot of money to interpreters. Deaf people don't earn a lot. I used to pay heavy amount to interpreters for the conversation. But
a lot of women with disability are not able to take this step, not because they can't be independent, just because they are scared of the challenges they will be facing, all the ridicule they have to face.
And with regards to my experience of living as a disabled person, as such, has been extremely challenging and complex, and it's going to be difficult to articulate that. However, I would want to highlight that more than our disabled bodies, it is the environment that we are living in that makes us feel more disabled, you know, and that needs to change.
Hello everyone, my name is Apoorv Kulkarni. I head accessibility and inclusion at the Ola Mobility Institute. We are a new age think tank creating knowledge frameworks at the intersection of mobility, innovation, and public good. I grew up with a disability. I have a visual condition which makes it difficult for me to see properly, to navigate or to drive a vehicle. And so growing up, I have always found myself depending on others for my mobility needs, which was an incredibly constraining experience, especially in the formative years. Later in life, as I grew up and gathered new experiences, I was able to see how transport systems could be incredibly different in different parts of the world. I have worked across 3 continents in various capacities, right from technology to public policy to business, and have had the good fortune of also studying abroad for my MBA at Stanford University. All of these experiences really opened my mind and heart. When I saw the transport systems out in the West, which were really empowering and which could enable you to travel independently for yourself, I reflected on my own life and realized how incredibly different the outcome could have been if the same facilities were available in our country over here. Therefore, I have worked relentlessly to improve the accessibility of transport ecosystem in India. Cities are really growth engines of our economy. Because of the various opportunities, various facilities that are available in cities, you see talented people from all across the country flocking to major urban centers. This transition is only going to continue. For an urban environment to be really work as the growth engine, we also need transport ecosystem to be functional, not just functional, in fact, to be at a scale, at a level where it empowers the citizens of that particular urban environment. And to that effect, I think investing in transport systems that are safe, accessible, reliable, and affordable would go a long way in creating an infrastructure that will stand the test of time, that will be sustainable, that will be resilient, and that will be with us for decades to come, fueling the growth story of the particular city and the country as a whole.
My name is Dr. Anubha Mahajan. I am a dentist and I am the founder of Chronic Pain India. So through Chronic Pain India, we work for people living with severe chronic illnesses, invisible disabilities, and rare diseases. I live with one of such a condition too. I live with complex regional pain syndrome. It's an invisible disability which impacts my neuromuscular system. It's a rare condition. There's no cure to it. And it is not easy to live with it because it hampers my movement and mobility to some extent. And there are times when I cannot speak and I have to navigate around the people by actions and movement and express and tell them what I'm going through. There are times when the walks are too long and, you know, there is no, you don't have any vehicle around it and you have to walk too much and my body cannot do that. And I have to consider going on a wheelchair at such hours because I can't just walk for too long. And yeah, I mean, these challenges just come and go and come back. That's the reason it's an invisible disability. My major request to city planners would be that consider having apartments disabled friendly. Consider having accessibility in the apartments. Have sensitization drills for the security and for the management team of apartments and societies. Another message I have for people who are building these societies and all. Please consider having at least 5% of your society, housing societies, 5 to 10% of your housing societies an apartment disabled friendly, as in the houses are already built in a manner that they are accessible for people with disabilities and they don't have to house hunt in that way. And they know that there are certain amount or set number of houses in this particular area or building that are accessible already, and it will make things very easy for people living with disabilities.
She wants that all the historical places in our India must have interpreters, so that the people who are deaf and who love to visit historical monuments now, they will know what is the history of that monument. I require that the sign language should be there in put the official language. There are many languages which are registered in East, in West, in North, in South. Everyone has sign language. All the languages are not officially registered. But that ISLRTC, they are having the dictionary, the word dictionary. Once the language is officially registered now, this will help us in getting accessibility, and more people will empower will get empowered through this.
Okay. Hi, my name is Shweta Mantri. I am from Pune. I am a writer, stand-up comic, and a disability inclusion enabler. My experience of living in Pune for more than 3 decades has been a mixed bag of emotions because every day is different. However, I'd want to say that it's good to see a change that's happening because, for example, if I would step out earlier to watch movies in a theater, I'd hardly get to watch movies in a space or in a theater that had a toilet, a Western style toilet. But it's good to see that there are more accessible options for me today, where I can expand my social bandwidth and have a decent social life. Having said that, I want to say that this is just the beginning. I do really hope that we can bring about change at a faster rate, where the city becomes inclusive, not only to me as a person with crutches, but it becomes more accessible and barrier-free for all people with disabilities. Be it people who are wheelchair users, people who are blind, or people who are deaf and hard of hearing. So I'm definitely rooting for a sustainable change to happen.
She's saying that one must herself, like, I must first empower myself and then I'll empower many people and then they will empower us. And through this chain, we will do a lot. Like empowering through sign, that deaf people empowering through sign language, for black people empowering through braille. And if we use accessibility for all them, we'll empower them in any ways.
See, people living with disability, it doesn't mean that we are less of a person than anybody else. We have our own capabilities. We navigate through the day as you do. We work, we eat, we dance, we sing as normally as you all do. It's just we have a little quirks and we live around it. It's not stopped us from working. It's not stopped us from doing things around us. So rather than seeing people with disability with an eye lower, see them with an equal eye and try to imbibe it. You would might end up having a great friend that you might have not come across, or you might come across a very humorous person you might have not met before. Be a little sensitive around issues, because these issues, these illnesses, disability don't come knocking on your door. They happen. It can happen to anybody. It can happen in your own family. You don't know. It's just that being a little mindful about it, being sensitive about it, you're not just doing a favor to the other person, you're also doing a favor to yourself and your family and everybody else also.
And through this program of NIUA, I'm hoping that we are able to address the mindsets of people and bring about a change that will eventually lead to a physical change in infrastructure that will be more accommodating towards the needs of people with disabilities and give them the tools to lead a regular happy life that they want to.
As a member of the advisory committee of the BASAIC program, I think I see great potential of this program making a big difference. Any tangible difference in the urban ecosystem, in the transport ecosystem, needs various stakeholders to work together. And these include stakeholders, let's say from the government side, across various levels, across national, state and local level, as well as it needs non-government stakeholders from civil society to private bodies, entrepreneurs and businesses and what have you, right? Even the stakeholders in terms of the commuters themselves to really come together so that improvements are brought in on the ground in daily experiences. NIUA's work through the BASAIC program is really pivotal because it is helping bring all of these stakeholders together on a common platform. It is helping the planners, for example, understand the needs of persons with disabilities. And it is helping persons with disability communicate their experiences to the people who can make a difference. It's providing a blueprint by looking at various guidelines, various standards for improving built environment. And it's going to really create a baseline of sorts wherein you know, those interested in improving the accessibility are able to refer it and are able to feel empowered, informed to take the right kind of action. So I feel that there's a huge potential NIUA through its reach across various levels of government is doing great work through BASAIC program in creating the right policy infrastructure, right policy background, and creating enough material which can then serve as a jumping off point for others to take off and to create more accessible, more inclusive products and services for urban planning, for urban communities, for transport systems and what have you.